And welcome back to Travel in Chinese. I'm Mark Rosewell, otherwise known as Da Shan. In our series to date, we've been following Huang Renhao and his family as they arrive in Beijing. We followed them through all the formalities of going through customs and picking up their luggage, taking a taxi to the hotel and checking in. There, they made a few phone calls to contact their local relatives to get together for dinner. After that, we went back to the beginning and reviewed all of the information that we've learned to date. Well, today, we're going to learn something new. We're going to follow Huang Renhao and Xue Mei as they make a photocopy, send a fax, and mail some letters. All very practical information. Let's see what happens in today's dialogue.
你好。你好，我想把这份材料和这个护照复印一下。这份材料是单面印还是双面印？双面的吧。护照印哪一页？哦，第一页和有签证的那一页。
先生，您看看，
签证上面的照片印的不太清楚啊。可能复印机有点问题，对不起，我再帮您重印一张。复印，这个怎么样？嗯，这个复印的不错。哎，你们这能发传真吗？我要发一封传真。
传真机在这边，这边请。
啊，好。
国内的还是国际的？
国际的。啊。
传真号是多少？
给你这张纸，上面写着传真号。传真号好了。好，谢谢。多少钱？一共10元钱。好。好，谢谢。
哎，老公，你在这儿。
雪梅，我来发传真，你呢？我要去寄券，你陪我去吧。好，走。是寄给妈妈的吗？是的，所以要寄airmail。那叫寄航空信。哟，这么重啊！这封信肯定超重了。
有十几张照片的，全是小件照的。那就寄挂号信吧，别丢了。
挂号信稍微慢一点，得10天左右。嗨，可是安全呀。
走吧，我正好啊要买套明信片呢。哎，老公，邮局在这边。走。Okay, let's go through this dialogue step by step. Huang Renhao has gone to the business center to make some copies of his passport. 复印 means to copy. 复印好了, says the clerk. The copying is done. Unfortunately, the passport photo isn't very clear. 护照上的相片印得不太清楚。得 is used to indicate the extent of a verb or adjective. In this case, 印得不太清楚. It's not printed very clearly.
你好。你好，我想把这份材料和这个护照复印一下。这份材料是单面印还是双面印？双面的吧。护照印哪一页？哦。
第一页和有签证的那一页。复印好了，先生，您看看。签证上面的照片印的不太清楚啊。可能复印机有点问题，对不起，我再帮您重印一张。对不起，
I'm sorry, says the clerk. 我们再给您重印一张。We'll make another copy for you. 重 is to repeat. 重印 means to copy again. Next, Huang Renhao needs to send a fax. 你们这儿能发传真吧? Can you send a fax here? Or, you can send a fax here, right? He hands over the page to be faxed. 上边写着传真号. The fax number is written on the page.
这个怎么样?
嗯，这个复印的不错。哎，你们这能发传真吗？我要发一封传真。
传真机在这边，这边请。
啊，好。
国内的还是国际的？
国际的。啊。
传真号是多少？
好，给你这张纸，上面写着传真号。
Xue Mei comes in. She's going to send something by airmail, 航空信. Unfortunately, Huang Renhao tells her the letter is probably over the weight limit. It's full of pictures that Xiao Jie has been taking. Better send it by registered mail, 挂号信。
寄给妈妈的吗？
是的，所以要寄 airmail。
那叫寄航空信。哟，这么重啊！这封信肯定超重了。
有十几张照片的，全是小介照的。
那就寄挂号信吧，别丢了。
挂号信稍微慢一点儿，得十天左右。Registered mail is a little slower. It'll take approximately 10 days. 稍微 indicates just a slight amount. In this case, perhaps a day or two.Now, we just talked about this character, 得, a minute ago. Here it serves a different purpose, and it's pronounced differently. 得, to require. 得十天, it will require 10 days.
那就寄挂号信吧,别丢了。
挂号信稍微慢一点,得十天左右。
嗨,可是安全呀。走吧,我正好啊,要买套明信片呢。
哎,老公,邮局在这边。
走。
Time for a tea break. The mail service in China is fairly quick and reliable. In today's lesson, we learned 航空信, airmail, and 挂号信, registered mail. Most letters will arrive within a day or two, within the same city, a few days to other cities within China, and a week or more for international letters. If that's not fast enough, you could consider 特快专递, express courier,Couriers can usually provide same-day service within the same city or one- or two-day service to other cities in China. Domestic courier service is relatively cheap, but international service is expensive and will probably still take at least a few days. Your hotel can help you with most of these postal services. For parcels, 包裹, you should probably go to the local post office. International parcels may have to be checked by a customs agent before they're sealed and sent out. Now let's take a moment to review some of the language points that came up in the dialogue. For example, 的 with a verb or adjective. This shows the extent of an action or state. For example, 他汉语说得很好. He speaks Chinese very well. 他汉语说得很好. Here's another example. 雨下得很大. It's raining very heavily. 雨下得很大. Let's look at another language point.稍微, a slight amount. 他比你稍微高一点. He's a little bit taller than you. 他比你稍微高一点. Here's another example. 这个菜稍微有点咸. This dish is a little salty. 这个菜稍微有点咸.
这份材料是单面印还是双面印？
双面的吧。
护照印哪页？
哦。第一页和有签证的那一页。
复印好了，先生您看看。
签证上面的照片印得不太清楚呀。
可能复印机有点问题，对不起，我再帮您重印一张。
是寄给妈妈的吗？
是的，所以要寄 airmail。
那叫寄航空信。哟，这么重啊！这封信肯定超重了。
有十几张照片的，全是小介照的。
那就寄挂号信吧，别丢了。
挂号信稍微慢一点，得十天左右。
套 ，indicating a set of something. For example, 我想买一套中国的邮票。I'd like to buy a set of Chinese stamps. 我想买一套中国的邮票。你买的这套衣服很好看。This set of clothing you bought is really attractive. 你买的这套衣服很好看。Let's go back to the dialogue now and see how they use these language points.
那就寄挂号信吧，别丢了。
挂号信稍微慢一点，得十天左右。
嗨，可是安全呀。走吧，我正好啊要买套明信片呢。
哎，老公，邮局在这边。
走。
We came across a few sentence patterns in this lesson that would be good for some substitution exercises. For example, 好 after a verb, indicating that the action has been completed.
去上海的机票已经买好了。
The air ticket for Shanghai has already been bought. 去上海的机票已经买好了。Let's try some substitutions with this verb followed by 好。
请把这件行李放好。
请把这件行李放好。
您要的出租车已经订好了。
您要的出租车已经订好了。
Here's another pattern. Verb plus 这。这 after a verb or adjective shows that the action or state is continuing. For example, 她穿着红色的毛衣。She's wearing a red sweater. The action is continuing. She's still wearing it. 她穿着红色的毛衣。Let's try some substitutions with verb or adjective plus 这。
桌上放着一本字典。
桌上放着一本字典。
门锁着呢，我进不去。
门锁着呢，我进不去。
你好。
你好，我想把这份材料和这个护照复印一下。
这份材料是单面印还是双面印？
双面的吧。
护照印哪一页？
哦。第一页和有签证的那一页。
复印好了，先生您看看。
签证上面的照片印得不太清楚呀。
可能复印机有点问题，对不起，我再帮您重印一张。复印，这个怎么样？
这个复印的不错。哎，你们这能发传真吗？我要发一封传真。
传真机在这边，这边请。
啊，好。
国内的还是国际的？
国际的。啊。
传真号是多少？
哦，给你这张纸，上面写着传真号。好，谢谢。多少钱？
一共10元钱。
好。好，谢谢。
哎，老公，你在这儿？
雪梅，我来发传真，你呢？
我要去寄券，你陪我去吧。
好，走。是寄给妈妈的吗？
是的，所以要寄 airmail。
那叫寄航空信。这么重啊，这封信肯定超重了。
有10几张照片的，全是小介照的。
那就寄挂号信吧，别丢了。
挂号信稍微慢一点，得10天左右。
嗨，可是安全呀。走吧，我正好啊要买套明信片呢。
哎，老公，邮局在这边。
走。
Well, in today's lesson, we've been learning about very practical things like making photocopies, 复印。Sending a fax, 发传真, or mailing letters, 寄信. So many choices to make. 单面还是双面, one-sided or double-sided. 航空信还是挂号信, regular airmail or registered mail. Well, in the next lesson, we're going to be doing something just as practical, but a little bit more fun, because 雪梅is going to a beauty parlor to have her hair done. We'll see you then. 再见.